Following sequence table and object shows the data that he obtained. Determine the range and interpreter range for the data. Okay, so given this table, okay, and then this is the object, okay. So you need to find the range and interpreter range. So for interpreter range, of course, you need to have you need to find from the graph here. Okay, the range. Okay, so we start off to find the range. Okay, so the range is the highest minus the lowest, or the biggest minus smallest. So we can refer back to the class interval, the mass in gram. Okay, the highest over here, the lowest over here. So we use the midpoint to minus. Okay, so 900 plus 999 divided by 2 minus 400 plus 499 divided by 2. So both minus the difference of it, you will get the answer 500 gram. Okay, so it's also called difference between the heaviest pineapple and the lightest pineapple is 500 gram. Okay. This one no need to write unless they ask you to tell me the difference between heaviest and lightest pineapple. Just write the answer is enough. 500 gram. Okay, gram. Then you need to find interquarter range. So to find interquarter range, you must remember how to find interquarter. Okay, range. It means the third quarter minus the first quarter. Okay. So we find the first quarter first. Okay. So I make the graph bigger so that you can find the values from the graph. So the first quarter is 1 over 4 times the total frequency. That means when you add up everything, the number of pineapples, you will get 80. So 1 over 4 times 80, you get 20. So from the graph, 20 from the vertical axis, go straight over here, goes down. Then you calculate what is the value over here. So if it is 599.5, it is 699.5. So you can use calculator and calculate. 699.5 minus 599.5 divided by 10. So each of it is 10. So if it is 599.5, here will be 609.5. Here will be 619.5. So answer is between 609.5 and 619.5. So any answer between that, between the both of the, okay, values. But make sure do not put your answer 609.5 or 619.5. Okay, so you can put 614.5. That is the first quarter, and you need to find the third quarter. 3 over 4 times 80 total frequency you get from calculator is 60. So from the graph, 60 vertical axis, okay, dotted line using pencil goes down. When you touch the graph, straight goes down. Okay, this is 799.5, so plus 10 is 809.5. So answer is 809.5. So your interquarter range is the third quarter minus the first quarter, you get 195 gram. So it's called difference between the heaviest pineapple and the lightest pineapple that lies in the middle. 50% of distribution is 195 gram. So we continue with variance and standard deviation. Okay, variance is the average of the square of the difference between each data and the mean. Okay, so we got a formula. Why you say that? Okay, the average. Okay, is because you divide the total frequency. Okay, average of the square x square. Okay. difference between the data, this data, and the mean. Okay. Standard deviation is a measure of dispersion. So the standard deviation is square root of variance. Measure of dispersion relative, okay, to the meaning of relative to is in comparison with its mean. Okay, so we compare to mean, okay, which is measured in the same unit of the original data. Okay. So we look at example 10. Okay, earlier on, okay, we have learned that to find variance is sum of x squared over sum of frequency minus mean square. Okay, they don't put f in front, but now we have to put f in front because it involves midpoint x and the frequency. Okay, if only involve x, there's no frequency. Okay, then we don't use the f in front for the formula. The table shows the volume of water in the nearest liters used daily by a group of families in the housing area. Calculate the variance and standard deviation of the data. So of course you need to build a new table, okay, to find the variance and standard deviation. Because the formula, you have the f, you have the x squared, you need to keep from the table. Okay, you have to create the table so that it's easier for you to find the answer. So we start with volume of water, we go over here. So 150 to 159 until 200 to 209. This is a number of this is frequency. So it's the unit is the symbol is f for frequency. So 8 until 16. So 8 until 16 total frequency. When you add up together, you get a sum of frequency is 95. So for the midpoint, that means you need to add up and divide by 2. 150 plus 159 divided by 2, you get 154.5. Until 200 plus 209 divided by 2, you get 204.5. So from here, you can see it's uniform. So the answer also for me point easier. No need to calculate every time. So just see this is 104.5. So here will be 164.5, 174.5, 184.5. 94.5 and 209.4.5. So this is called x. Okay. So we always refer to a formula because variance are we need to have this formula EF x squared over EF minus EF x over EF. Okay. So you need to get the F, you need to get the x squared and also F x squared and also F. Okay, so you need to get fx and x squared and fx squared. Okay, so f times x, 8 times 154.5, you get 1236 until 16 times 204.5, you get 3272. Okay, because you need the sum of fx. So the sum of f add up together, you get 17,417.5. Then you need to have the x squared first so that you can multiply the f later on. Okay. Why you need to find this one like this? So that it's better than safe than sorry. Yeah? So you won't get you won't make more mistakes. Okay. So x squared means 154.5 squared, you get this one, 23,870.25. And for over here will be 204.5 squared, you get 41,820.25. Then you need to find fx squared. So fx squared will be f times x squared, 8 times 23,870.25, you get 190,962. And for over here will be 16 times 41,820.25 to get 669,124. Then you add up all together because you need to take sum of square. Okay, 3,215,133.75. Okay. Find variance. Before finding variance, you need to find the mean first. So the mean is sum of x over sum of f. For those without f, usually it's sum of x over sum of f. So we need to add the f in front. So that's why we use this formula. Okay, this is for group data. Okay. Sum of x over f is for ungrouped data. So sum of fx will be 17,417.5 divided by sum of f. So you get 95. You get answer 183.34 liter. Okay. And after finding mean, find the variance. The variance is sum of fx squared over sum of f minus mean squared. This formula is given in SPM. So sum of fx squared is 3 million plus. So over there, over sum of f is 95. Then minus the mean. Okay. When you minus the mean, I take this one. 17,417.5 over 95. I don't straight away take this one. Okay. Because, okay, why this one? You don't take this one. This one is to show that your answer in two decimal places because of volume. Usually, when you locate the volume or anything, usually run off in two decimal places. So when you want to do not run off two decimal places too early, you take accurate values. If you run off two decimal places too early, then over here, the final answer will be the accurate answer over here. Okay, so you run off because when you use calculator and calculate, okay, 17,417.5 divided by 95, you got 183.3421053. Okay, unless you get the four decimal places behind there, that is better. Okay, not better straight away use this one in fraction because you haven't divided anything yet. Then it's more accurate. Then only you minus, remember to square it, square the mean. So using calculator, okay, you get the answer in 229.1856. Okay, then for variance, if you want to round off, the answer will be 229.19, because 5 and above 1 plus 1, okay, liter square. Okay. Then to find standard deviation is square root of the variance. So when you square root of the variance, you use this one also. Okay? You don't use this one, 2 decimal places. Okay? You use the 4 decimal places at least. Okay? So square root either 4 or 3 decimal places, you will get the final answer nearer to the actual answer. Okay? So if let's say I square root 229.1856, 15.138877 more. So when you round off to 2 decimal places, become 15.14. Okay. If let's say I square root the answer 229.1863 decimal places. I will get 15.13889032, it means 15.14. So if I say I have square root 2 decimal places, 229.19. Okay, luckily this answer is similar, 15.139. But the thing is, can you see the time is a bit bigger? Okay, you will also get 15.14, but it won't happen in most of the cases. Usually the third one, if you use the 2 decimal places, the answer will be different from the actual answer. Okay, so they are completed in finding variance answer and standard deviation. So you can use calculator to check your answers. Okay. So your calculator must be at least Casio MX570. Okay. So from here we can use the text below. Okay, so you press mode, press one time, twice. The press once you get COMP and CMPLX complex. So press N time, you can find this SD, REG, and this. You need to press one, okay? Press one for the SD standard deviation. So you press one, okay? There's SD on top, and enter the midpoint, okay? Enter the midpoint. 4.5. Okay. 4.5. And press shift. And press comma. Press frequency. Okay. Frequency. And press frequency. Yeah, press M plus. I think it's frequency. This frequency 154.5, then you press shift, then you press comma, then you press the frequency 8, then you press M plus, okay, then you get N equal to 8. So yeah. Okay, we repeat the method again. Okay, press the point 164.5, then press shift, then press comma, then press 12, then press M plus. You get N equal to 20. Okay, then press again. 174.5 shift comma 15 and M plus. Okay, N equal to 35. Then 184.5 and shift comma 24 M plus, N equal to 59. Then 94.5 shift comma 20 plus 10 equal to 79, and finally 204.5 and shift comma 16 and plus 10 equal to 95. And from here the three step will be you press AC, okay, the bottom one, I don't press the corner. AC, then press shift, then press number 2, then come up with min, and then I think it's a min, okay, 1 is for min, 2 is for standard deviation, okay, so if I want to press 1, cool. 183.34, correct. If I want to hit the standard deviation, I can press AC again, and press shift 2, press 2, equal, again, 15.13887696, that is 15.14. Okay, so right, that is the method to find the answer. Okay, you can try it out, but it's very complicated. I don't think you can remember the steps well, unless you always use it to get your answer. Okay, so remember to